Hi everyone, I'm Mr. Eddie Sun. Today I'm going to go through two experiments which are related to enzymes. Let's get started. The first experiment is related to a protein digesting enzyme, protease. These proteases can break down the white milk protein, casein, into colorless peptides. In case you don't know, it is casein that makes the color of the milk white. If we add protease into a milk agar plate, the white milk agar will turn colorless. This colorless region is what we call a clear zone. Here is what a real milk agar plate looks like. In this milk agar plate, there are three wells. We can add protease solutions inside these wells. In order to make these wells, we can use a straw or use a cork borer to remove part of the milk agar on the milk agar plate. So, how should we carry out this experiment? First, different protease solutions are added. Then, the milk agar plate is put into an oven with a suitable temperature so that the protease works best. After several hours, observe whether there are any clear zones formed near the wells. Remember, a clear zone is formed when the white milk proteins are being digested. Therefore, the larger the clear zone, the higher the protease activity it is. Now, look at this. Which condition shows the highest rate of reaction? Give you some time to think about this. If you have chosen this one, you are right. Protease mixed with the pH 8 alkali solution gives a higher enzyme activity than the protease mixed with the pH 9 solution, as indicated by its larger clear zone. However, when we compare the results of these two wells, what information can we get? As we cannot observe any clear zone here with only the pH 8 alkali solution, it proves that the clear zone formed near this well is due to the presence of protease, but not the pH 8 alkali solution itself. Okay, now let's go to the second experiment. The aim of the second experiment is to investigate the effect of temperature on amylase activity. Amylase is the enzyme that converts starch into maltose. Before the reaction starts in this experiment, we have to make sure both the amylase solution and starch solution are of their designated temperatures. In this diagram here, we have 6 pairs of solution put into 6 water baths with 6 different temperatures. After about 10 minutes, the amylase solution can mix with the starch solution and we can start counting the time for reaction to take place. After 2 minutes, draw a drop of reaction mixture out and add it into the iodine drops on a prepared spot plate. In case the iodine solutions turn blue-black, it shows that starch is still present in the mixture and thus the reaction has not completed. Repeat this at 2-minute intervals until iodine solution remains brown. When the iodine solution remains brown, it shows that starch is absent in the mixture. When all the starch in the mixture has been broken down, the reaction has completed. Here, the results of 3 different temperatures are shown. Which condition shows the highest rate of reaction this time? Yes, at 40 degrees Celsius, the reaction ends before the 8th minute, as no more starch can be detected in the 8th minute. This shows that the rate of reaction is the highest at 40 degrees Celsius. At 60 degrees Celsius, the rate of reaction is the lowest. It takes much more time for all the starch to be broken down. Probably it is because of the denaturation of amylase at higher temperature. Okay, that's all I have prepared. In the test or exams, you may see different experiments. Anyways, hope you at least have some ideas about these two enzyme-related experiments. See you next time. Goodbye, class.